Speaking to the media at the Uganda Media Center, Mr. John Osapiri, the Chief Executive Officer, Uganda Christian Lawyers Fraternity, said that the conference will bring together distinguished speakers to mentor and equip the youth on entrepreneurship and intrapreneurship as a matter of addressing issues of unemployment, where Uganda has got one of the world's youngest population, about 78% under the age of 30 unemployed, posing challenges of high dependency, violence and crime. The Inspector General of Government and also a board member of the Uganda Lawyers Fraternity, Dr. Achan Patricia, said that as legal practitioners, it's their obligation to inculcate principles and values to ensure that the youth grow up with morals and engage into the fight against corruption.
This is a wonderful opportunity for us to demonstrate partnership and strategic alliance with the press again in this cause. Uganda Christian Lawyers Fraternity is an association of Christian legal practitioners, like the CEO aptly explained. We do legal aid, we work to ensure that there are values among the youth. We want to inculcate principles and values to ensure that the youth grow up with morals, the youth grow up as God-fearing people, the youth contribute to the fight against corruption. Now that I'm the deputy IGG, I believe that if our youth come up with skills, comes up with values and are creative, then they will be able to even put aside the issues of corruption and be responsible and contribute towards the good of this country by monitoring the government projects, monitoring the activities, monitoring the development activities taking place around, and being able to point out areas which need improvement.
Dr. Patricia said that she believed the youth can develop skills of creativity so they can contribute to the good of the country. Due to the COVID-19 situation, the convention will be conducted under strict observance of...
Uganda has one of the youngest populations in the world, with about 78% under the age of 30, something that poses a challenge in terms of unemployment, high dependency, violence and crime. However, we can leverage on this potential for development. This can be done through intentional human capital development, done through skilling, retooling, attitude and mindset change, and promoting education that touches the head, the heart, and the hands. This convention, therefore, presents us with the opportunity to harness, but also channel the abilities for our youth for economic development. Therefore, as non-government organizations, we call upon the youth from every part of the country to attend this convention online. We are certain that as youth, we shall be mentored and inspired to pursue our dreams and life aspirations through this event. We implore parents and caregivers to give their children to attend this online event. Together, we can build a nation that we desire.
With the standard operating procedures, where a limited number of participants will physically attend and the other youth are encouraged to join via online platforms. TV Africa News, Kachanchu Mtabazi, reporting.